Everybody, Cypher Boy here with another episode of The Walking Dead No Man's Land. And here we just promoted Daryl Dixon to level 2, I believe, and got a new ability for him. So, just got the newcomer's bonus. Finish training this one here. And finish training Anne. And now we're going for training. Let's see who it is. Ricardo. Gotta remember to grab those walkers so you can get the experience points. As you can see, I'm at level 5 at the moment. Let's see, I get a new survivor here. And it's Michelle. Here I'm still waiting to get the upgrade for the council trader. And we get Glenn right here. So now we got Daryl and Glenn. So that's pretty cool. I played this one already, so I'm just doing the voiceover for now. And promoted him as well and unlocked the lucky thing. So here we're finally going to the missions. And I'm going to replace Ken with Glenn to try him out. And the magic of editing got rid of that loading screen that took forever, so that's pretty cool. And here we are in the first battle of the video. It seems they're going towards the little garage thing right there. Walkers with heavy armor, so that means you have to use was it again? I guess the melee weapons. They went by too fast for me to read, but here we have Sue. And it's time to go to the exit before any more walkers show up. Which did not happen, but we have Daryl taking some out for extra experience points.
Okay.
hope everyone's enjoying the different zombie games for October. I was looking for like scary games, but I'm always drawn to the zombie ones. I wanted to play some from last year, but I was concerned that the graphics would make them quote unquote kid friendly or whatever, so I didn't want to risk that for the channel, so I went with the dark and kind of gory type of games. Here we have Ryan, which I picked so he can use his bat. That way I've got three of each kind of characters here. And I'm just having to take care of the walkers here before I go to the glowing items on the screen. And each time I open one, some more walkers show up as a result, because they're like hidden or hiding from your characters here. I think this is the battle with that one of them that I got heavily damaged, and I needed to have the characters in the medical tent for a long time. If I remember, I think that's how it went for this one. I know there's some in the future episodes. I've got some already recorded and had to upload them to my Dropbox so I can put them on the computer, edit them, add music and the voiceovers and all the other stuff so I can upload them and everything, schedule them out. And I already got a bunch of videos ready to be edited for November, so hopefully I can do one video every day for November as well. I'm going to be working on those this month. And normally I can upload maybe 2 videos a day, because it takes about an hour for each one to upload. So here I'm just getting the characters to the exit so they can leave. Got another victory, and okay, they're not heavily damaged, but they're just bruised at the moment. And I'm pretty sure the 4th episode, that's where it goes downhill really bad. And thankfully they don't seem to die if they lose all the health. They just go unconscious and then have to be in the tent for a longer period of time. Prison voices. Completion of reward is the kitchen cleaver. Wonder how good that is compared to Glenn's knife. Here I'm just equipping them with all the higher level weapons. I probably should have given Glenn that particular knife. I don't know why I didn't do so. Maybe because he was ready for the medical tent and I wanted to get on with the next battle. So I just switched them out temporarily. before I forget to say so, since I'm just going through this part now, if anytime you want to speed up the video, go ahead and click on these settings and then 2x speed or whichever speed you want to. It'll make, like, this video is 16 minutes long. It'll cut it down to half to 8 minutes. That's how I always watch YouTube videos, or most of them anyway. That comes in really handy too, so that's a good thing. And here is where we get to kill the walkers through the fence to keep the characters away from them. As you can see, the little gate is glowing, so it takes a little bit for the characters to open that thing up. In the meantime, the rest of them can kill the walkers for good through the fences. That way they're safe from the walkers, as you saw there. They're just wandering around. If you want to join my Patreon, which is going to be down in the description below, and I'll also have a call to action that seems to cause it in the video if you wanted to check it out and see what it's all about. For that one, I mostly, well, pretty much it's all writing, like tips on writing and chapter snippets of work I'm currently working on. And pretty soon I'll be having a book out. It's Dracula, but it's translated to a different language. So anyone who speaks that language, that's all for you. So for the Dracula book, I have maybe, I want to say, 5 chapters left to do. So I'm hoping to finish that up sometime this week and get it out for people in time for Halloween. I'll have more details on that later, but after it's published and gone through the Smashwords website. So here we're just going through the final walkers on the right hand side. Pretty sure there's some more hiding back there though. Yeah, there's 2 more. How long it takes me to get through. So we hear the broadcast from the guy that's trapped in the net of the military base. So now we have to go through it to the exit here. Almost there. Yeah, we got hit though. And here we go, we won this one. I cannot wait to get the medical tent back up because then, or not back up, but leveled up so I can get two people at the same time getting killed at the same time. Thank you.